Christ the devil. Ask him when he asks you what you dream or what this number mean. Rebuke them in the name of Jesus. Come on.
Hallelujah. Amen. So, you must work. And you should declare, my family and I must start. We're not shortchanged the God-given talents we have. We will not look for a free ride. Man and protector of your family. Do not allow the devil to walk in and drive a wedge between you and your wife. Do not allow him to turn you against your children and them against you. Push back against the resentment or resentment in the family. Push back against impatience. Push back against rebellion and every work of the enemy. Take full authority. Take full authority over your home. Name of Jesus Christ. Stand guard and do not allow the strong man to enter, plunder, and cast asunder. I want to say that again. Stand guard and do not allow the strong man to enter, plunder, and cast asunder. And you are the lover. I could put the next to you and say, lover. Lover, not lover. 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 Love your family. Sacrifice for your family. Step out in faith with your family. Forgive where forgiveness is required. And seek forgiveness where it is expected. Of course, there is a role in the family for the wife, for the mother. So let's talk about the wife. You are not a doormat. Put your hand on your bosom and say, I am not a doormat. Say it straight. I am not a doormat. So no man like a doormat, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Praise be to God. Give the Lord a clap of praise. Thank you. You're not a doormat. You're not a child. You're not a child. You're not a child. Don't act like a child with your husband. You are not a child. You are not a slave, and certainly you are not your husband's slave. Now, I don't want no husband to go home after listening to your mind as a partner, even though they say, you are not a child, you are not a doormat, you are not a slave. Amen. And don't be afraid of your husband. Some women go into a state of terror when they see their husband, when they are in the presence of their husband. Relax yourself. That's your flesh. Praise God. Better John, I don't want them to be afraid of you. What is that? You get old and you get cranky and she sees right there with you. And then they come to visit, go see her right there. I don't want them to be any good. Listen. As you age, you should be better. This is the shouting message. I make no excuses for this message. We need to help our people. Many of God's people are living broken down lives, but God can help us. And He can control our marriage to the extent that we can model good family lives for our children. They can be more effective Christians in the church. So, you are your husband's helpmeet. And when you look at that in its original, what it means is that, come here very quickly, Kaifa, come here very quickly. Come here, from here. I counseled with them for like 6 months or so. Before, because I couldn't marry them, so I have license to lose them. This word, help me. The word help me means that, and it's original, it's phrase, means that. Today is not in the back of Kaifa, but in the back of him. We've already established she's not in the front of him. But this word, this phrase, means that the helpmeet is a partner alongside. They complement they complete each other. You know what I said to them, and you know what I said to everyone that I counseled before marriage, in 3 to 6 months time after the wedding, I want to come for one final session. You should put it as I come in my checkout list, I come to tweak. I ask you, how's the sex? How's the money? How's communication? How are you in laws? Etc. Because after we talked about who can be in charge ticking off. And once I say everything is fine, I say goodbye. I wish you again we have problems. So they opened you. They opened you, isn't it? I told them, if you don't come to me, I'll come to you. And of course, you might say that. But you understand the devil wants to destroy families. And when you destroy families, it's the root. He effectively destroys the worship of God in the church. That's why we need to talk about this. I said, it's the elephant in the room. The devil don't want us to talk about family life and family problems. So we sit in church. I'll let the pin light up. And I'll have problems for the Lord. But in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord wants us to address it and to deal with it wherever it is. Now, I don't know anything about
declare, my family and I, these are some declarations.
pride of mine now. Declare, my family and I will pray. My family and I will love. It's a declaration. My family and I will worship. My family and I will live out the word of God. My family and I will face our challenges head on. The devil would like for you to deal with problems. The devil likes you to sweep it under the cover, under the rug, and to say stuff like, well, the Lord can deal with it. No. You confront it in the name of Jesus Christ. And you agree, disagree. Now you are just God, right? So you are still trying to find common ground. I don't know anything about you, but I know you are individuals. I love you. And so as you're trying to find common ground, somebody step on the line every now and then. You can dwell on that. You'll be a bit more fun. You're 2 or 3 weeks later, we talked about what happened 3 weeks ago, which we didn't deal with 3 weeks ago. Deal with it now. Deal with it now. In the name of Jesus, deal with it. My family and I will declare our trust in God. It's a declaration. My family and I will be a people of character, integrity, and loyalty. My family and I will praise God despite our circumstances. Many Sundays people come in this church and they don't have a whole lot of things. But I watch them as a good thing. And when they lift their hands, I can see the electrifying church. Portfolio to praise God. The psalmist simply says in the psalmist, let everything that hath breath praise God. But you just lift your hands now and just praise Him. Everything hath breath, praise God. Come on, empty, praise the Lord. Pain is come, praise the Lord.
Cross my mind and get upset. Praise